If you want to increase the connectedness of your Minecraft server, adding public transport is a great way to do this. From building simple roads to rail networks and eventually other modes of transportation, you can increase the immersion of your Minecraft server by making it more interconnected. We're going to show you what our Minecraft server looks like after 3+ years of adding these modes of public transit to make our Minecraft server even more connected. From highways to rail networks, subways, airports, maritime transportation, and even more. I hope you learned something that you can take into your own server.
Hello everyone, this is Vodup.
Now you've all seen Vodup in our previous videos, so we're going to be showing you what our mass transit network is in our server to get from one corner of our server to the next and in between with different modes of transportation, from subways to rail lines, airports, boats,
horses.
There's all sorts of wonderful ways that you can add this level of immersion to your server. So let's start with the basic pathways. We talked about how every town there's a planned out street grid network. So there's these paths here and all the streets are named something unique, and each business has an address. But looking outside the gates of the city, we move on to uncharted territory.
This is uncharted territory.
Yeah, so we're not in the safety of Vodup anymore, are we?
No, this is going to be completely new stuff that no one has ever seen before except for us.
To get to our capital city, so this is our first town, and we want to, this is the first path we made, so it's very simple. It's going to turn into something called the Silk Road, which is the the main road that leads to the capital, and there's lots of businesses, lots of threats along the way too, so you have to watch your back.
Yeah, watch out.
There's a jail for the county that was added later.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, and just more pathways to go on. So, upon reaching this point, we have two choices. So this road here, this long concrete road, this is part of our horse highway network. What is that, Kim?
The horse highway is a highway that you can use your horse on to get from point A to point B.
And it's very quick because there's no obstructions, there's no speed limit. It's completely flat and level every single where. There's not like an elevation drop or increase anywhere, and that's so it's just increases in efficiency. And there's many exit and on ramps, just like a normal highway or interstate. So that's just the fastest way to get around by horse or on foot. But this didn't exist until at least a year after we started the server. So of course we just had these simple pathways between cities. Oh my gosh. You'll see lots of interesting creations along the way. This is another on-ramp to the highway too. So there's that. But this has received a lot of renovations over the years. This leads into one of our subway stations for this town. Parking lots. And these businesses, and there were many more of these stalls, but they were taken down after illicit activities were occurring here.
This is the black market, so many illegal activities.
Yes, lots of money laundering for sure. But now we keep a mall here that's pretty massive, but we'll have to cover that another day. But yeah, so this was the long Silk Road that's all under the highway here. And this leads into our capital city, Toydaria.
Oh my goodness.
This is the most historic city of our server, my friends.
Basically the nexus of our server.
Yep. This is where it all happened. You can tell by these hollowed grounds we stand on.
Oh my goodness.
Look at this. This is historic.
It's history right here.
So originally, this town used to house like a naturally generated village, like a spruce or taiga village. I don't remember what it was. But
we can even see like one of the original buildings.
Let's go. Let's check it out. This is the last existing natural structure. Traditional Toydarian house. And the cool thing about this village is some of it was on the ground, but some of it was on this hill.
Oh, yeah.
And this is the first road, Valley Road. And where this rail line here, it used to come in through here, but like we mentioned in our first video, we shuttled the villagers from this village all the way to vote up down this line and drop them into their new town. We asked permission.
Yeah, for permission, of
They
course.
said yes. So yeah, this is a historic line, but it since has been rerouted down there. But yes, so this is what the style of the housing used to be, and we've preserved it as a historical site. But yes, anyways, so the capital houses several different is a hub for many different transportation modes. The most important one is probably this building here, is Grand Building. What is
Oh yeah,
this?
this is Grand Central Station. And this is where you can take the railroad system that we've created and to many different cities that we've created.
There's three different major lines here that go to different parts of the server. And there's an information desk here that you can get directions.
Yeah, they
There's
take you
a
to different counties and everything.
this is a giant map of our server zoomed out, but it's not up to date, so we have to fix that.
Yeah.
But it shows it's pretty big. And so our transportation network is ruled by a government agency called the OTA, and they basically control all the fares and the rules and the laws for all of our networks. It's a very, I don't know what this display glass is for, but I had intentions. So, yeah, this is where the headquarters are. And of course, you gotta have an ATM nearby.
Oh yeah, that's very important. Keep your IDs in here,
That's true.
passports, all that good stuff.
So I like the style of it. We use this marble-looking block called calcite to show to you know to for the pillars. I think it's cool. But yeah, so I don't even know where to begin. There's so many different routes we could take.
We try the south line.
That does go to an airport, yeah. So we do that, go through the turnstiles. And before we used to have this charge of fare, but that doesn't matter anymore. So
Let's see.
this line here goes to our airport. This is our major airport, so maybe we should just try this one.
Let's do it.
Arriving at the terminal here, and lots of old mine carts are here. And this line just brings you back to Grand Central Station. So it's good to have a network, to your major hubs, from like airports and things like that. Looks like we have some fellow travelers here. But the cool thing is that horse highway we were talking about from the beginning connects all the way over here. So there's like three different ways to, actually four different ways with the subway that we haven't talked about, but for like this major airport, you need to have multiple ways for people to get there. And there's also like a pedway here where you can actually walk. This is pretty new, but this is just like a sidewalk that connects. I don't know if you remember that.
No,
Okay.
I
So after we came from there, we can go down to the departures here. And this is where you would drop your passport into this hopper, and then the officer on the other end would inspect it. Oh. And then they could check your ID in there.
Oh, yeah. Always make sure you have a security.
Flight suit.
Yeah.
Neat.
Keep things secure. Retrieve items right here.
Yep, so I failed to show what that looked like, but yeah, for security reasons, you would put something in another hopper and then retrieve it in here after you've been cleared. And what is this guy? And this would bring you to the runway. So you would go over here, pick up your flight suit, which is just a damaged elytra, so you couldn't, you know, use it afterwards if you stole it and didn't return it. And then some fuel.
So and then probably grab we're off.
Yep. So you would go onto this. We only added this little platform because it's kind of hard to start flight without any like drop in elevation.
Yeah, that's true.
So you would drop, and then you would start flying. I'm failed.
Me too.
But you would follow these little beacons, so you kind of have a flight path. And the route we're taking right now, you're seeing some new towns too. This is the newest town. But here is Vodup. We've seen Vodup before. And we would just follow these big beacons. Make sure we reach elevation. And then this would lead us to our second airport. So that's the whole point, is to travel large distances from the air.
Mm.
This is North Fannin. This is a new town. It's very large. Follow these beacons as they get closer. And we find runway 32.
My goodness. Yes.
So this is the newest airport. It's smaller, but has a lot more bells and whistles. So we would go to... this goes to another rail station here. So this is just another nexus on a different side of the server. And we'll go back to the airport terminal in a second, but there's more connections to Asopolis Park, which we showed in our last video. Check it out up here.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Another cool thing is there's a rooftop restaurant in our station, so it's always good to feed hungry travelers.
Yeah.
And it's a Angie's wraparound.
Rooftop bar.
That's right. And there's a nice bar here. The kitchen's in there. There's just so much.
Yeah, so good.
I love it.
I like the... I intentionally try to... Well, this was like supposed to be a castle before, but turned into a train station.
Yes, it was vacant for a while, and then we finally renovated it. And that was really cool. So it's a train station with a restaurant. But let's go back to the runway of this airport. And so you would exit here to get back into the terminal. Go up these stairs. This is just a long corridor. And this would be the security checkpoint once you arrive. So there's a booth here. The Asopolis Guard is the military police presence. And they would inspect you before you go on, just like the other airport. And this is the terminal that anyone can come into. This is where you can buy some passes, some fares from the OTA, which we mentioned. So they set all these rates, and they're not cheap, but they're reliable because you can get anywhere with a pass.
True.
There's supposed to be a food court here, but that didn't happen. There's a bathroom.
Oh, I guess not. For all.
Oh my gosh, this is great.
Oh.
Looks this is nasty. Ugh.
Yikes.
Toilet paper.
Yeah, these are mass produced right
And the cool thing is this also has a subway line underground. We haven't really shown much of the subway, but we can get a sneak peek. So this leads to other major cities. It's very long. My gosh, it's so deep.
Jeez.
But yeah, so this is our subway. Our subway is entirely underground for the most part. And this leads to different places. So, yeah. We can go to Elysium, which is a town, city we haven't seen yet.
Oh, yeah, let's do it.
So, it's kind of long. Maybe we should just fly.
Okay. Well, you get the general idea of it.
Pretend that we're on the minecart. And the subways are very long and extensive. Oopsie.
Mm.
That wasn't too bad.
Yeah.
But now, so I think every town has a subway network, so everything is interconnected underground by rail.
Mm.
And these are what the entrances look like with those signature turnstiles. But this is one of our favorite cities that we'll have to show in some detail eventually.
Oh, yeah.
This is Elysium. It's a Eastern-inspired city with like lots of cherry blossoms and ancient architecture.
Oh
and
man,
a
yeah, it's
river
pretty
that cuts through it.
good. The Jade River, I believe.
Something like that.
Jade, yeah, something like that. Yeah, it's so nice.
This is the town hall here, if you can't guess already, but we digress. And this was one of the newer towns, and you can see how different the inner w roads of the city are, all these paved pathways compared to
Yeah, much more
Vodeb's.
modernized
Yeah.
design of the way we do things.
For sure.
This is more accurate to what we do now.
And the cool thing about the bodies of water, which we haven't even mentioned yet, is that these are also interconnected to the rest of the server, so you can travel by boat through the entire server, which is a cool it's a cool network. Oh yeah, so there's another subway connection down here at this corporate building. This condominiums here.
Oh, yep.
And these are the fares that you can purchase. Again, it's pretty much a direct copy. And this goes to another town. And we put some warnings. And you would go this way, yeah. You put your minecart down. Which.
Don't even, where does this go?
This goes to North Fannin.
Oh.
And what was that sign? West of
West of
Southwest. So, yeah,
Southwest.
we make little landmark points when you cross different jurisdictions, but you can't really tell because it's just a long path here in this, yeah, West Asopolis. And yeah, this is just a very long corridor. Great. So this, yeah, and we kind of put a little marker here. It's 598 blocks long, so it's just a long pathway.
Quite a travel.
Yep, so this is one of our biggest cities. North Fannin, and their underground rail network connects to three separate nodes. So this goes to Hinsdale, which is another town near Vodup, and this goes to Archanea, which is we should check out Archanea.
Ooh, yeah, that's a good place.
So just like the
Let's
other
do it.
one, you would go there. And the point of this is just to show that everything can be interconnected underground with the rail network. It's just one of the many ways to get around, and the signs should help point you to the right direction you want to go. And just like the other ones, this can connect to another place. So this can go back to Vodup, Toydaria, which is the capital. We like to spice up our subway stations. There's.
You never really know what you're gonna find in some of these places.
Exactly. There's another network here. This goes to Halloween Town, which I don't even remember having a
Oh yeah,
network there.
that's barely a town.
Yep. And we always show like the road that the station's located on. And this just kind of transport you. It's like a portal almost. You're underground for so long, and you emerge and you're in a completely brand new area.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yep, so this is another town.
One
There's
of
a
our newer
church
ones.
here, yeah. So very cool. And then this is the West Sea, so this connects to all the major towns like Vodup and Fannin, which is over there. North Fannin's over there.
Should we check out more of the maritime
Yeah.
travel? Do it.
So let's just get on a boat. So the major bodies of water are all interconnected, and you can pretty much go anywhere. Oh, you're on my boat.
I'm here.
Great. So in the water, we have these military warships here just to make sure that a peace is being maintained.
Always gotta make sure
Yeah,
rule is in order.
this is true. There's a lot of lighthouses too near major cities, just so you don't get lost when it's storming out. This is Vodup. We've already seen this.
You know about it?
Just a different view of it. Yeah, little did we know that this major body of water here is gonna be able to connect all across our server.
It's pretty impressive, I have to say.
Yeah, and there's another rail line over there, and these are all interconnected in some way or another. We're approaching Bartleyville, which is the newest city. Some luxury apartments up there, some yachts for the rich.
Yeah,
And we have
that's great.
these little beacon points here for a Vodup Games event. And if you don't know what the Vodup Games are, you have to check out our last video,
Yeah,
please.
it's the only way. You have to know what it is.
more horse highway here, so we'll have to add some support pillars because they look like they're floating, but
yeah.
So yeah, there's a horse highway there. Above us is the rail network on these large suspended bridges.
Teen Titan Tower, right there.
Teen Titan Tower. This is Slab City. This is our Slab Beach. It's a resort. So more lighthouses. This is the main beach in our town. So if you want to relax for a weekend getaway, you would go here, go fishing.
This place actually has the one and only Trident Golf Course.
Oh yes. Well, oh my gosh. Yeah, we'll have to show Trident Golf, but there's a large, I believe it is 18 holes of golf there.
Oh, I think it's just 9.
Oh, that'd be cool if it was 18.
Yeah.
Sometimes it feels like 18, but no, it's only 9.
Yeah.
So this is just like a getaway kind of town. And we're going to be approaching some uninhabited land here, which is... Oh, no, this is part of the golf course. It's just big.
Oh, yeah.
And we're almost approaching the end of our stop. Ooh, yes. Up ahead, if it loads. This is a private house. Private property.
Yeah, very, very private.
Yep, this is a mansion owned by one of the wealthier inhabitants of our server, and we should check it out sometime. This is a man-made canal, so part of the bodies of water didn't exactly connect, so we had to make some room. We gotta fix these pillars too.
Yeah.
But this is this is true. This is horse highway stuff. And then above us, to our left, is another private mansion that is in the distance, but there's a chapel that they own and their own boathouse there.
Yeah.
More horse highway over there. You can see some of the mansion over there.
Lots of mansions on the near the sea.
Mm-hmm. And we're approaching our end of the connections via this major body of water. There's other smaller rivers and lakes, but this is probably the largest one. And you gotta avoid the lily pads, which is the tricky part. This is our only swamp town.
Yeah, this is Swampin City.
Swampin City. Which is a really cool one.
Yeah, basically a town on the water here with these floating kind of bridges that connect them all, mm-hmm. paths.
Yep. That's wasn't even cool. Like a village here. We made this from scratch.
Yeah.
Here's like a pretty stage cool. for public concerts.
There's a mud mall.
We gotta show Mud Mall sometime.
Oh yeah, we gotta do that. But it's a pretty small town.
Mm-hmm. Even the swamp town has access to major public networks or public transport networks. This is part of the Votive Games. This is another amphitheater. And a hotel there. Oh, I forgot about this hotel. That's a really cool hotel.
Oh, that's a very cool. Yeah, check that out sometime.
We should do a hotel episode next.
Oh yeah, there's so many cool hotels.
Yeah. Okay, but let's go to the train station. Just like we mentioned, every town has to have a train station.
It's pretty much a must in every single major town.
It doesn't have a subway for obvious reasons because of the water. It makes it difficult.
Yeah.
But of course. So here's an information desk. And this heads to Roswell Station, which is where the if we can just imagine being on this minecart. This one's very twisty and turny, and oh, the gallows.
Oh yeah, you gotta have the gallows. That's another main tip. I can give you top ten.
This one's
right kind
of cool. It just kind of winds down this valley, and this is a rail line that actually goes underground. It needs to be renovated. It's very primitive. We didn't.
Yeah,
fix this.
We need to still furnish it a little bit more. But
yep. So this station, there's another connection to a different line that heads to our main university town, along those snowy mountaintops. But that one of the mansions is located here, and they have their rail network that's available to anyone. And this heads back to our old downtown area. So it's just nice to have one state, you know, a station that can house multiple lines. And that leads to this train station in Brotherwood, and has access to the downtown area here through these gates, goes to the capital city over there, and yeah, and this goes straight to the airport as well, so that's nice.
Pretty big train station.
Just has to protect you from the elements and
Oh yeah.
keeps mobs out with these gates.
Very true.
But yes. So bringing it back to Asopolis, and oh, I forgot about this map. This is a map of our server that we try to keep updated, but this just shows you the monstrosity of our creations right now and how far things reach.
It's
That's the
pretty
airport.
ginormous.
We're currently in this town here, but we went all around, and if we can show vote up here, which is right here, this is the West Sea that we were on, that harbor. Archanea was there with the lighthouses, and then we took a boat all the way around Slab Beach and then through that canal through Swampin City. So it just shows that not we didn't even show the top part of the server and how the water can connect, but everything's accessible by these horse highways here, which are the gray lines, and underground via the subway stations and the airports. And even if you don't take those rail lines, you can always just walk between towns through just like simple pathways like this, just like this gate. And now you're in a new town. So
If things get too complicated, you could always use, slash warp.
ooh, yeah, so a plugin in our server allows us to instantly warp just when we want to make it fast and don't care about storytelling. So we do slash warp, and then we make w these warp zones for some of the major areas. It doesn't contain every town, but contains most. And this is just the fastest way to get around, so can instantly teleport across thousands of blocks in one go. So if you have the option to do that, you can, with like a mod or a plugin. But if you don't and you play vanilla, then you would just use the rail networks or the elytras for flying. But yeah, we just scratched the surface of this network. There's so many more stations that are we haven't even looked at, but
Yeah,
it's the principle that
that's the main.
matters.
It's the main. We got the main gist of our system.
So hopefully this gives you some ideas to add mass transit to your server. It just makes it more immersive and fun and connected in different ways. But
Yeah.
with that being said,
I think I'm out.
I'm out.